Mike Corliss of Tormach. Today we're installing the tailstock in the Tormach slant lathe. Okay. Let's talk about the tailstock a little bit before I install it, just because it's a lot easier to see a lot of this stuff while it's on the bench here. These are the locking bolts on the backside here. After you get it all adjusted for your center height, this is what you're going to lock it down with, okay? This is going to keep all your adjustments for moving after you get it adjusted, okay? You can see this. This is on a wedge here, okay? These jack screws are going to push this back, and that raises your center height, okay? And then for your center distance this way, you've got a jack screw on each end. So one there and one there. And they're going to fight against each other. So if you go to adjust one, you got to loosen the other one first, okay? So it drives it back and forth. This is the plate that locks against the ways. And after you slide the tailstock into place, you slide this plate in, and then you tighten. There's two set screws here, and they fit into the detents on this plate. Okay? All right. Now, once we have this in place on the lathe, what I'm going to do is I'm going to slide this live center in, and then I'm actually going to indicate the center in so it's true with the spindle on the lathe, okay? Because this is what's actually going to be on my workpiece, so this is what I want to dial in. You could also if you didn't want to dial your center in, you could also indicate the taper of the tailstock, okay? Before you can install the tailstock, you have to remove the Z-axis limit switch plate. Make sure your ways are clean. And then slide the tailstock on. You slide this plate in along the way. Just make sure you have the detents orientated the right way, okay? You want them, they're offset a little bit to the top. That's how you want to slide it in, okay? You slide it in, and then you tighten the set screws in, and you can feel it when they just start into the detent. There's that one. There's that one. Now, if you tighten these up all the way, you're not going to be able to slide the tailstock. Okay. So loosen them up. Then you can slide the tailstock and get it positioned where you want. Okay, and what you want to do is have the tailstock in the position where you're going to be using it. However long your part is, that's where you want to lock your tailstock down and indicate it in. Okay. We'll just clamp it down like right here. And this is what this is where we'll indicate it in. I'm going to install the center so I can indicate the center in by adjusting the tailstock. Okay, so now I have my tailstock where I need it to be as far as how long my part's going to be. And I just put a Tormach tool holder drill chuck in the spindle to hold my indicator. And then I'll just dial the center in until it touches. Okay, so now just by running my indicator on the front and back side, I can see I have to shift my tailstock up. And then once I get the X pretty close, then we'll check our vertical height. This is adjusting our center this way in X. With these jack screws?
Yeah.
To drive it this way, you have to tighten the bottom one. The only way you can tighten the bottom screw is if you loosen the top one, okay? Now I've gone just a little past. We'll bring it back. Okay, so we're a little bit low with our center, so we'll have to tighten these jack screws down here to drive it up the ramp, the wedge. And that'll raise our center. Okay, so you adjust your front, and that's going to adjust your height here. And then your jack screws the top of the bottom, that's going to move your this way. Okay, and you just keep sneaking up on it until you get your indicator to read zero in the front, or the top, the bottom, and on the top here, or in the front. And then snug down your clamping bolts. Okay. And you might, after you tighten these down, you might have to tweak it a little bit more, because if you got any play in there, it's going to change your center height. Okay. As you get it adjusted, so you get it to zero, just be careful when you're tightening it up. Just make sure everything stays centered, because sometimes when you're switching back and forth from moving it in X or vertically, the screws are kind of adjust the other axes too. Okay, so you got to keep sweeping around to make sure it's not changing on you. When you adjust one axis, it's not moving the other one a lot, okay? And then once you got it set up, you're ready to start throwing parts at it.